universally in mythology, and it's very helpful because, first of all, it de-isolates you. One of the things you learn as a clinical psychologist, contra the anti-psychiatrists, let's say, is that diagnosis is often a relief to people. You know, there's a problem with being diagnosed because then you might be labeled, and then the label can follow you for the rest of your life. And once you're labeled as something, then strange things happen around you that often reinforce that label. Maybe you start acting it out more, or you adopt it as an identity. But there's a flip side of that, which is that the last thing that you ever want to hear when you go see a physician or a psychologist is, you know, I've never seen a case like yours before. Right, that is not a relief, man, because if the message is I've never heard anything like what you're telling me, the outcome is either going to be not so good for you, or you're not going to get listened to at all, right? Because you're such an anomaly that your existence is annoying to the integrated knowledge structure of the medical professional that you're attempting to receive advice from. Well, it's definitely the case because, you know, if you can be put in a box, then the box tells the doctor what to do with you, and that's actually a relief to the doctor, but also a relief to you, right? Because you want to know. So you come and you say, look, I can't go out of my house much anymore. I'm afraid on elevators. I have heart palpitations, and I sometimes end up in the emergency room. Increasingly, my interactions in the world are restricted. I find myself staying at home, afraid I'm going to die of a heart attack. And the psychologist says, well, you have agoraphobia. It's like lots of people have that. And here's usually how it develops, and here's the treatment course. And, you know, we can probably do something about that. And it's like, well, you're not going to die of a heart attack now, probably. That's a real relief. You're not crazy in a completely unique way, and you're crazy in a way that might be treatable, you know? And it's such a relief because people come in there with a pile of snakes of indeterminate magnitude, and they walk out with one manageable snake, and it's still a snake, but, you know, one manageable snake beats a hydra.